Hello everyone. In today's tutorial, you will discover how to format your Samsung SSD for use on both Mac and Windows computers. The formatting process is the same whether you have a Samsung T5, T7, T9, or a different SSD brand. In this tutorial, I will use the Disk Utility app on macOS Sequoia and an external Samsung SSD T7. To start, connect your external SSD or hard disk drive to your MacBook Pro, MacBook Air, iMac, or Mac Mini. In this tutorial, I am using a MacBook Pro M1 running macOS Sequoia version 15.2. If the icon for your external SSD or hard disk drive doesn't appear on your Mac desktop, navigate to the Finder menu. If the Finder menu is not visible, click on the desktop or your screen to make it appear in the menu bar. Then select Settings in macOS Ventura, Sonoma, or Sequoia, or Preferences in older versions of macOS. In the Settings window, click the General tab and ensure the External Disks checkbox is ticked. After following these steps, you should see the icon for your Samsung SSD or other SSDs or hard disk drives on your desktop. Before formatting your drive, confirm that there are no important files on it. Formatting will permanently erase all your files, so make sure you have a backup. Next, open the Apple Disk Utility app by clicking the Spotlight search, typing Disk Utility, and pressing Enter on your keyboard. The Disk Utility application is in the Utilities folder inside your Applications folder. In Disk Utility, click the View icon and ensure that Show All Devices is selected. Then navigate to the left sidebar and click on your external drive, which is the top level drive under External. This is my external drive, and this one is the internal one. Therefore, I'll select the Samsung external SSD under External in the left sidebar. Let's take a closer look. When you select Show All Devices, you will see the Scheme menu. This view allows for more advanced management tasks such as partitioning a drive, erasing a disk, or working with containers and volumes directly. When Show All Devices is not selected, the Scheme menu is unavailable, making it less complicated and offering fewer options.
If you like this video, make sure to subscribe and ring the bell for more. Thank you.
Now, click the Erase button to format the disk. I need to choose a name for my SSD, since I want to format my Samsung SSD for use on both Mac and Windows. I'll type in Mac and Win. You can name it whatever you want. However, you can enter only 11 characters, including spaces. For the format type, we have two options: ExFAT and MS-DOS-FAT. ExFAT or ExFAT is an abbreviation for Extended File Allocation Table. ExFAT supports individual files larger than 4 GB. However, the maximum file size for MS-DOS FAT is 4 GB. ExFAT is generally preferred for modern use due to its support for larger files and partitions, as well as better performance. MS-DOS FAT is more suitable for older systems and smaller storage devices. Therefore, I select ExFAT. For the scheme, choose GUID partition map. It's a modern and versatile partitioning scheme. It allows for large drive sizes, supports multiple partitions, and is required for booting macOS on Intel and Apple Silicon Macs. You can now click the Erase button. If you made a mistake after clicking the Erase button, there is nothing to worry about. As long as you have backed up your files, you can always format your disk again. The formatting process has started and it will take a short time to complete. Click Done. Your drive is now ready to be used on both Mac and Windows computers. You just need to copy your files to it. I hope you learned something new today. If you did, please consider subscribing by clicking on my profile picture and sharing the video links with your friends. Your support will inspire me to create more videos for you. Thank you for watching.